His name. He is in our midst. This worship service would just be empty without Him. We can never catch God. It is Him who catches us. The very time and the very moment that we received the Lord, that was the appointed time for us. Today is another appointed time for an increase, for intimacy, for revelation, to be set apart, to be sanctified into the deeper things and more meaningful areas in our life, to unfold in a way that we can never dream of. The things of God are beyond our imagination. But from moment to moment, we can just have a glimpse, and it will prod us to move on, because we see something good, something wonderful, and we feel it in our spirit man. Today, as we come to Him, as He gives us a fresh revelation of who He is in our life, we are able to press on and press in. He places the fire in our hearts every time we get an experience of who He is. Today, continue in that journey. We have a journey today, a journey to go down deep into the heart of our Father. We never are stagnant. We're always moving on, moving up, and moving on. Father, we commend this house to You. We may have different struggles in our life, different challenges, different things, O Lord, that come against us. But nonetheless, these things that come at us try to hinder us from being passionate for You. There are things that are in Your heart. But God, we know that You have covered us with the blood of the Lamb. That every time something is thrown against us, You have already secured us, because You have marked us with a destiny. And today we want to reiterate, we want to pursue that destiny. Whatever it takes, Father, whatever You need to do, we yield in complete surrender, God. Because there is a reason. There is a cause. You have a purpose in our lives. And that adds more meaning from day to day, as You release a fresh revelation, understanding to us. We want to be better receivers, God, of Your love. We want to be the perfect recipients, Father, of the kingdom of heaven. We want, oh God, to be empowered beyond where we are today. We know everything in the kingdom of heaven is limitless. And we want to be limitless, God. Because our spirit man have been designed to have the capacity to be with You throughout eternity. Kingdom come. Let Your will be done. Let it be, God, that this moment, this morning service, will not just be another worship service. It will be the worship service that will prod us and bring us to far more mileage than we can ever had before. We thank You, God. In spite of everything, we are able to be here by Your grace. Merciful God, You have preserved us throughout the week, that You may continue, Lord, working in each of our lives, that we may become who we are supposed to be. We thank You, Father, for your faithfulness. This we, O God, thank you in Jesus' name. And everyone said, amen. God is good. Today is the second Sunday of November, and people are counting the number of days before Christmas, because for many, Christmas is the most joyous time because it has brought with it the promise of our Savior. But ever since the Lord was brought here, every time He was birthed into this world, into this life, we should celebrate Jesus every day, including this day. For every day is a journey into Him and through Him. Every day is an opportunity to be blessed and to be a blessing. Every day there is an opportunity to grow and mature by leaps and bounds. To the proportion that we receive Him, to the level that we are yielded to Him, in great proportion, we shall grow and receive more. Today we declare that the passion for Christ in us, the passion for the Father and for His plans and purpose for us as a person, as a family, even as a house, it will have a greater increase and intensity. For that is what we desire, and as we ask of it, truly we shall receive. We would like to invite to the pulpit today Pastor Troy Cordero, who comes from Cotabato City. He is the itinerant evangelist of Hope Church, and he is also the representative of NFS for ARMM area. Let's give the Lord a warm round of applause. God is good.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Praise God. Glad to be here. My plan was to rest today. And Pastor Aaron invited me. It's a real privilege to be here in the house of God. May I request you to bow your heads, please? Father, we open up our hearts today. We pray, Father, as we align ourselves in your purpose and will, let there be a download of your revelation upon us today. Give us today our bread, Father. We desire you. We long for you. Thank you, because your love is already poured out, and we are desiring to enjoy your love in our lives, moment to moment. Thank you for quickening our spirits today. In Jesus' name, amen. I'd like to share a scripture found in Ephesians chapter 3, verse 20. Sabi ko doon, now unto Him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly more than we ask or think or imagine, according to the power that is at work within us. Are you familiar with that verse? Sa hindi po nakakilala sa akin, ako po ay si Troy Cordero. I am married with 4 kids, dalawang batch po yan. Isang asawa lang, of course. The first batch, Dakuna. And the gap with between the second and the third is 15 years. And my journey in the love of the Father ay nagsimula ng almost 3 years na rin. Halos magkasunod-sunod kasi kami ng NFS team ng Mindanao. And sa umpisa ng journey, after receiving the revelation of Father's love, parang nagkaroon ng realignment ng lahat ng bagay sa buhay. Nung after a few weeks, when we had this encounter, parang nangapa kami. Kaming mag-asawa kasi sabay-sabay kami. Parang we were hindi namin alam kung anong mangyayaring sunod. Kasi na-realign lahat sa term ng iba, gusto kong hiramin, parang na-born again, ngayon lang na-born again. Yung paradigm, yung mindset na nandito sa akin, sa amin, for many, many years, sa isang iglap, just the touch of life from the bosom of the Father realigned everything. And it changed everything. From relationships, from perspective, sa lahat, sa intimacy, the way we serve God, nag-change lahat. It was quite an awesome journey. While hindi lahat pleasant, because the more we expose our hearts, the more we expose ourselves to the love of the Father, the more our hearts are exposed. Alam ko po kayo nag-journey rin, di po ba? Pero ang experience namin, the more na we always open our hearts, the more na expose yung hearts natin. At the more natin na realize we need Father's love every day. We need Father's love every day. The more we push in the bosom of the Father, the more we discover na wala na ilaing way where we receive life in this life while serving Him here on earth. As believers, it's God's will that we must elevate. Nung una kasi ang paradigm natin pag sinabing elevate, we strive more. God wanted us to level up our standards of living, pero naka-align sa Father's love. More importantly, dapat maintindihan natin at ma-receive natin that God wants us to grow in all aspects of our life by His grace and love. Alam ko po, alam natin that we are spirit beings with body and soul, not the other way around, that we are a body that has a soul and a spirit. We are spirit beings. And God's purpose for our lives, yung ating destiny, even before we were born, Father already charted where we should go. And it's for us to respond. We were made for eternity, not just for this lifetime. Karamihan sa atin, pag tinatanong mo siya, ang life expectancy nila, napakaisip. Sinasabi nila, siguro 50 years na lang, 30 years na lang, lalo na yung may edad-edad na, muingon sila nga, siguro mga 20 years na lang, tagay na kong 20 years doon ang Ginoo. But when we encounter Father's love, we begin to understand nag-a-unfold yung eternity sa atin. And we were made for eternity, not just for this lifetime. Maraming mga tao, they just prepare for this lifetime. And they got untol sila kay never expected. Maraming mga problema ang dumarating. Sometimes even death comes. Hangtod ito lang din ang ilang lifetime. But to us, God's people, we were made for eternity. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, tapad mo, you are made for eternity. So dapat ang paradigm natin, hindi lang dito, it should be beyond what we see every day, beyond what we experience every day, because we are made for eternity. Father God has a good plan for each and every one of us. And we have to believe that. God has never planned a destruction in your life. Father has never planned a defeat in your life. God has a good plan for your life. And you have to believe that. Father created us for a purpose. We are not an accident. Hindi po tayo na accident, hindi lang nibuto ang aris kalibutan. Boom! Oh, nahanak na tao na. Diba? Other people, ganyan ang mindset. That is why they have no direction. Pag may problema, they easily get discouraged because walang purpose ang life. Maraming mga tao, maraming pangarap sa buhay, and yet they were not able to fulfill their destiny. Major reason, because they wanted to do it in their own way. Ang uban po, tisting-tisting lang. Kung asang successful, asang comfortable. Alala ko, we were studying sa Bible school sa Diyosang City. I have a very good friend na classmate na isa siyang lumad sa Diyosang Sarangani. Nung wala pang bus, nung unang panahon ng kwento nila, ang mga tao sinasakyan, puro mga animals. Kalabaw, kabayo, baka. Dumating ang time, dumating ng mga bus company. Lahat ng mga kapatid na lumad, alanganin silang sumakay ng bus, lalo na hindi nakasubok sumakay. So yung mga nakasakay na, kukwento sila, masarap sumakay ng bus pero kailangan alam mo kung saan ka bababa, natatandaan mo. Dahil pag tinanong ko ng konduktor, alam mo kung saan ka hinto, sisigaw ka na para bababa ka. So, to make the story short, there was one na sumakay ng bus. Pinakinggan niya, inalala niya, he tried to remember yung instructions na kasama niya. Sabi niya, basta manaog na ka, musingit ka, para. Kaya kung di ka mo para, di ka kanaog kung asa ka damit manaog. So, dagan ang bus. After a few minutes, 30 minutes na dagan, yung tinood ka ng istorya, basta kibinuangan lang sa akong kaugan, testingan daw na ako. Itindog siya, nung siya, para! Ingon sa konduktor, manaog ka, sir? Dili, nag-testing lang ko. Lingkod siya. Tapos after mga an hour na biyahe, tindog na po siya, basig na sa iyo, lang ito ganyan. Ingon sa konduktor, manaog ka? Kaya sigit naman po siya, para! Siyempre, mag-inor ang bus. Nihan ang konduktor, manaog ka? Niya, dili, nag-testing lang ko. Ikanawa, ingon sa konduktor, mo-testing pa ka, ikatulo, bantay ka. Hapit na ilang balay. Tindog siya. Pag tindog, yung sa konduktor, unsa? Ngayon niya, nalampas mo yun niya, tuwara mong balay. Tuwara mong balay. Sometimes, yung ating attitude, ganun. Gusto lang natin subok-subukan ng Diyos. Kung asa ta mo testing mo sa tanaw na to, asa ta comfortable, asa ta we feel good sa mga butang ibuhat na ito, basik ba unoy kabubuton sa Diyos? Sometimes we question when we are caught in the midst of confusion kung atong ginabuhat ba sa Ginoo dili. Pangutala ta, asa naman ka Ginoo? Ilan po sa atin ang dumating sa minsan sumagi sa isip natin? Eh dapat hindi tayo magtatanong yan. Dapat ang magtatanong ang Diyos, ikaw ang nasaan? Kasi pataka lang na kung asa ka pa dulo. Kung asa ka comfortable, sa imo sa tanaw ni mo, makayo sa imo, puro pang sarili. We will never fulfill our eternal destiny if we will do it with our own strength and determination. Now we learn with the revelation ng the two trees in the garden. If we eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, it speaks of our own self-determination and self-effort. And kasagaran ang malipay atong kaugalingon lang. Gusto ng Father that we will just receive from Him. Because the economy of God is receiving. It's not striving. Amen? Lisod ba yan? Mag-adjust? Pero as we receive download of revelation, we begin to understand. Kasi kung striving, we begin to boast. Ipaningkamutan mo na ito. Pero kung panalangin, always pinatulo na mo sa mga training, kung imong ipaningkamutan, once ipanalanginan ka sa imong tanaw panalangin, dili matawag panalangin. Bayad sa imong hago. Amen? But when the blessing just comes to you without self-effort, that is a blessing. Wala ni mo gipadihutan, wala ni mo gipanangkamutan, basta it just came. It's Father's blessing. Hindi ka pwede magpasigarbo at tungod maguli sa akong kayo, sa akong kabrayt. There is a man in the Bible Sa Old Testament na alam, kilala natin lahat. He is from Mesopotamia, galing ng Iraq. He was a nobody. Then one day, God called him and gave him a promise to the father, to be a father of many nations. Gave him a promise na ang seed niya will be numerous as the stars and as the sun. At sa kanyang seed, the promise was fulfilled. Kilala po natin ito. This is Abraham. Something in the life of Abraham na nakita ng father that he has to call Abraham. Sa dinami-dami ng tao, imagine from Genesis 1 to 11, nag-focus sa ibang creation. Pagdating sa Genesis 12, nag-change ang focus. Napunta sa isang tao. And he called Abraham from Iraq or Mesopotamia, from Ur. Kasi yung Ur is the capital of, sabi siya na Ur, the capital of Chaldean Empire. It's found in Iraq, or the ancient Iraq is called Mesopotamia. God called Abraham, and father said, leave your country. I'm going to show you the land na promise ko para sa descendants mo. To make the story short, Abraham obeyed. Familiar kahit sa story. But there are some principles na gusto na ko i-share sa life ni Abraham. Some of you here maybe knows this principle. But today I stand, gusto kong i-share ulit at i-remind us o i-steer up these principles in our lives. Because when Abraham called God from nothing, kung humanly speaking, from nothing to nothing. Because before him, when God called him, there was nothing. Sa physical realm, there was nothing. But God called him for a purpose. Sa buhay po natin ngayong umaga, mga kapatid, do you understand and do you believe that there is no accident in your life? God has called you for a purpose. It doesn't matter ano ang antas mo sa buhay. Kaya ikaw ay nasa middle class, sa lower class, upper class, anuman ang antas ng pinag-aralan mo, mataas ang level ng education mo, o hindi ka nakapagtapos ng pag-aaral. God has called you. God has a purpose for your life. The five principles na nakita ko sa life ni Abraham. Abraham had an open heart. Hindi niya kilala ang Diyos. But he knew in his inner man when God called him because he has an open heart. Kahit gaano ka kagaling, kung ang heart mo sirado, you cannot hear from God. Tinuturo namin palagi sa mga trainings, napakadali mag-close, but it's hard to open our hearts. Especially when we have experienced maraming mga traumatic experiences, maraming pain, maraming shame in this journey, lalo na hindi pa natin na-discover ang Father's love. Mahirap po mag-open ang heart. Especially kung pakiramdam mo, threatened ka. Automatic, your heart is closed. But Abraham had an open heart that you heard from God. When you heard from God, yung spirit niya nag-respond. Imagine you are living in a place na hindi sikat, or by the time sikat ang earth, kasi yan po ay capital ng Chaldean Empire. Imagine Abraham kung sa tingin niya, hindi siya significant sa harap ng mga tao. He's a nobody. Bigla lang sumulpot ang pangalan niya, Abraham. He was a nobody. But God called him. Today sa tingin mo, you are nobody. But I want to reaffirm God's call for your life. He has called you. Kumusta man ang heart natin? Jeremiah 17, the heart is the most deceitful above all things. Who can see it? In a moment, banal masyado ang heart mo. In a split second, again, your heart is full of negative things. In a moment, You're full of joy. In a moment, grabe ang surge ng faith. In a moment, you are so blessed that in a moment, lust can enter, hatred can enter, anger can enter your heart. Kumusta man ang heart natin sa araw-araw na pamumuhay natin? When we are surrounded with our families, when we are surrounded sa opisina, sa negosyo, sa trabaho, kumusta man ang heart natin, mga igsoon? Minsan sa tingin natin ang gospel, parang cheap kung tingnan mo. Kasi halos lahat by grace. Pero ang gospel, napakataas ng standard. Kasi kahit hindi mo pa ginagawa, iniisip mo lang, you already did it. When you begin to meditate in your heart something, sa spirit realm is already done. So Abraham, when he obeyed God because he has an open heart, God deposited something in his life, in his heart. God called him to dream. Imagine sa sabi ka ng Panginoon, ang imong seed will be numerous as the stars. Can you imagine yourself? Ha? Nga naman, ingon ang Ginoo, muhangad ka sa langit, kung unsa kadaghan ng stars, mo na imong descendant, mo, duko ka. Desert kasi. Kung ano kakapal yung buhangin, ganun din karami yung descendants mo. Bakit hindi mention ng Diyos yung kilid at sa likod? Because ang tao pag discourage, dalawa lang ang tinitingnan. Muhangad o muingon, every time Abraham, muhangad siya, he begins to remember God's promises upon his heart. Every time Abraham utuko, mga tao nga discouraged, duha lang man, muhangad o muduko. Pag duko na gani ka, di ba, sa illustration, sipaw ng lata, kung sa'y masipa, di ba? Pero si Abraham, sa Ginoo, muhangad ka, muduko, there, you will see the dream that I have placed in your heart. Duko sa Abraham, oh, ingon ang Ginoo, ang unsa ka baga ang balas mo na akong descendant. Muhangad siya, oh, unsa ka baga ang stars. Maupod ang pagtuman sa sahan sa Ginoo. Our call sa pagpangalagad sa Ginoo is a call to dream. A call for eternity. A call to believe for the impossible. Abraham was nobody. Abraham has nothing until he reached Egypt. Then God blessed, started to bless him. Pero may sikreto doon in between sa journey niya. Kasi ang journey into eternity is not easy. Una, Jesus paid the price once and for all. Kaya nung pinako sa sakros, ano sabi ni Jesus? It is finished. Nothing can be added into it. The other word for finish is, it's complete. It's for you to receive it. It's only for you to receive it. Just receive it. Nganong dali man dawato ng salvation. But after we receive salvation, parang napakahirap na mag-move forward. The promise of God in Ezekiel, I will remove your heart of stone and I will give you a new heart, a heart of flesh. Sa Old Testament, yun ang sinabi. Sa New Testament, I will write the law in your hearts. Kaya issue palagi ang heart natin. Madaling magpatigas ng puso, mahirap buksan ang puso. Pero only Father's love. Kasi pag sarado ang puso mo, you cannot receive life. You cannot receive revelation. Pila sa ito ang naka-experience na at a moment's time, high ka sa presence. Tapos something came up, split seconds lang, agad-agad, nag-change ang atmosphere. Honestly, taas ka magdami. Paras pala tayo lahat. Pero as we discover Father's love, when we discover Father's love, mag-umisa ta sa journey, hindi po easy ang journey. Pero kahirap kasi mag-struggle na wala kang gawin. Kahit ang mga pastors, kahirap po sa kanila turuan na mag-receive. Kasi nasanay sa kaugalingong paningkamot o determination. Parang kahirap ang turuan, just relax and just receive. Kasi naanad na nga kung pwede makibiso maningkamot. Naanad na sa survival of the fittest. Naanad na nga kinahanglan ako yun yung sabi saya pa, Ilunggo kasi ako eh. Ako yun yung panihuton na mabuhat na ako eh. Kung sa'y dapat nga buhat. But we are, when we continue to journey, ang heart na to always open. Yung Father's love will envelop you. Every time I change ang situation in your midst. I have a daughter, si Andrea, si Sandra, ganun din. Second batch na mga anak namin. Gagmay pa sila. Kaya mga duha ka dagko, first batch, dagko naman. Ang isa minyo na, nanakuya po duha. Pero ang ikaduhang anak, my only son. Tapos ang panganay ko na babae ay nagtatrabaho sa OPAP. Executive Assistant siya ng Turkish Ambassador. So, dagko na sila. Ang pagpadako na ako sa duha na ako kaanak na first batch, lahi sa pagpadako na ako sa duha kaanak na ako nga second batch. So, kining duha nga anak na ako nga second batch, nagsugod kami sa journey sa Father's love. And, daghang mga experiences na among nato na na-receive sa journey, ug nakita na ako, nagmamanifest. Now, one time, we were in General Santos City, ang akong anak, dagan-dagan din sa compound sa Hope Ministries, na dagma. Nung nadapa siya, nasugatan ang right niya na tuhod. Kami sa komidor, dagan sa hilak sa hanap kung saan ang tatay at nanay. Ako man yung nakita, dagan siya, gigakos na ako siya. Pagkakos, hilak sa yun ako, o anong nangyari sa'yo? Kikusgan mo ng syakit. Padapig ba? So, gigakos na ako, what happened to you? Wala sa kimik-imik, tanong ako yung tuhod, nasamad. Niduko ko, gihalukan na ako. Gigakos na ako siya. Sakit pa, bisag gasigang tuhod. Yung siya, wala na po. Imagine. Why? Because the touch of the Father brought comfort. The touch of the Father brought new courage. That's why in this life, kapag alagad ta, normal yun na nga masamdan ta. Lalo na, when our hearts are open, you become vulnerable. You become vulnerable sa abuses, you become vulnerable sa exploitation, kasi open ang heart mo. Vulnerable ka sa offense. Because pagtanong sa tao sa'yo mga malumong ka, ang tendency, i-manipulate ka. Ewan ko, na-experience nyo yan. Tapos every time na tanong, kasi open ang heart mo eh. People will begin to take advantage of you. Tapos bigla kang masaktan. Tapos, ay nalang nakapadres lang ko. Amen? Usahay ang mga taong i-expect pa niyo mga mo'y mo tabang ma-strengthen ka, sila naman maka-offensive mo. Tapos makaiwan ka. Praise God na lang. Mayo kay naka-father's love ko. Because at that moment, yun, your heart begins to experience pain. Father's love covers you and you receive comfort. And that comfort will make you move on. It will bring new courage in your life. It will push you. Bakit si Jesus was able to overcome? Imagine, tanang trials, tanang name calling, na-receive ni Jesus. Ipakarga ang cross to the point nga ilansap siya sa cross, gitawag pa siya ganap ni Satanas, gitoslok ang kilid, gikurunahan, giduplan, gilatigo. Pero as a sheep ready for slaughter, no words came out from his mouth except when he was hanging on the cross when he said, unusual pag yun, Father, forgive them. Even sa uban, because he is God. He is total and complete human when he was here on earth. Because Jesus modeled how is it to live in the love of the Father. Paano mamuhay na Puno ka ng Father's love in the midst ng opposition, in the midst of persecution, in the midst of problems. Jesus made his heart vulnerable, open. Kaya sabi sa mga disciples, I will not leave you comfortless. I will go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I will prepare a place for you so that where I am, there you will be also. Where he is living, where he is drawing strength, where he is being comforted, we can live there also. Abraham, bago siya naging Abraham, ang pangalan niya, Abram. From nothing, God called him. He received it in his heart. Pero kahit po may call siya, still yung heart niya vulnerable. May fear pa rin siya. Pero Abraham had an open heart. Second, Abraham has faith. He believed the impossible. He believed that God is able. Imagine ako nga si Abraham. Hindi niya kilala ang Diyos. But when he heard, he recognizes that his God, the Creator, called him. And everywhere he went, first he stopped niya sa Haran, sa Mesopotamia. Sabi ng Biblia, he built an altar unto the Lord. Merong inner knowing. Bawat tao ba yan may inner knowing that there is a supreme being? Pero hindi mo lang alam paano mag-respond. Nung una, wala pa tayong Father's love. Tayo palaging nag-i-initiate. I want to do this so that I can gain the favor of God. Gusto kong gawin ito. I will go to church. I will pray. Anong panalanginan ko? Di ba ganun man yung ating mindset noon? Ewan ko kung mag-agree kayo sa akin. Ganun din ako. I will try all my best to please God so that I will gain His favor. Pero baliktad pala eh. God has already favored us. God has already blessed us. It's for us to receive. When problems come, when our faith is being challenged, it's for us to respond to the love of the Father. Amen? Problem is, how can we respond to Father God kung sa earthly fathers may problema tayo? Pangatlo, Abraham understood intimacy. Bakit siya nagbibuild ng altar? Hindi niya gibuild ng altar to please the Father. He built an altar because it was his response to the calling of Father in his life. It was his response wherever we go. He understood intimacy. Father, I need to open my heart. I need to commune with you. Because ikaw nagtawag sa ako. Every day as he receives, God confirms and affirms his call upon his life. Sa atin po, nakaka-receive ba tayo ng confirmation ng Diyos? O ang basehan lang natin ng confirmation, gipanalanginan ko, maybe I'm on the right path. It's not all about material blessing. It's not all about money. It's not all about possession. Nakakalungkot kasi yung iba, yung basihan nila ng favor at pagpapala ng Diyos, material things lang. And one of the indicators na tinuro po, na experience namin, when you're walking in Father's love, mawala na yung desire mo sa material things because you become contented. Just the love of the Father, you become contented. His love is enough. And as we respond in that way, He provides. So wala pa akong nag-journey sa Father's love. I am working. Wala pa akong church. I tender at minister po ako. Nag-handle ako ng church for more than 20 years. Nag-give up po ako kasi hindi yun ang tawag sa akin. Nagtrabaho sa gobyerno. Senior technical staff ako ni Governor Hataman, Governor ng ARM. In charge ako, pirmi ko sa Iligan City, Cagayan. Kasi in charge ako sa pamana for MNLA program sa Lanao and Basilan. Area ko yung dalawang area na yan. I have a good earning. Marami pang perks. Then when I decided to resign, tatlong taon na po yung nakaraan. Laman may magot me. God provides. Yung anak ko, nung nag-aaral pa siya, every time na may need, di yun maguna-una magduha-duha mo yung sa papa. Pang tuition na, pang contribution, pang project. Sabi ko, masyado kang bilib sa tatay mo ba? Anong tingin mo sa tatay mo na mamulot ng pera? Eh, alam ko kasi tatay kita. Bisa ako mga gagmay, basta mula ka na. Baon po. Hindi sila nag-iisip o nagdadalang isip kung may pera ka ba o wala. They never ask question. Do you have money for this? Do you have money for that? Basta pag may need, pang. Kung meron tayong tatay, ganun din po yun. You don't need to worry. You don't need to ask unsang sign ka imo kung palalagilan. Because he is a father. If earthly fathers, kabalo mo panalangin sa ilang mga anak, how much more a heavenly father? Yung nga ni Jesus, ang earthly father, kung mga ayaw anak kong tinapay, tagad ba niyang bato? Tinapay niya. Kung mga ayaw bagista, tagad niyang halas? How much more the heavenly father? Yung realization ng if we seek him first, and all these things shall be added unto you. Imagine I travel kami, mag-travel kami, mag-training. I will be away. Pag-awa na ko sa balay. Kulihin na ako nga ng asawa ka. We have a father. And pilan hapit ko ang yan. Sige, travel. God provides. Noong nagtatrabaho sa gobyerno, nakusweldo pero kulang. Kulang, not enough. Kulang. Pero itong di ako nagtatrabaho, I have a father. He provides over, sobra-sobra. Grabe. Grabe siya. Lavish kung magmahal. Hallelujah. Abraham understood intimacy. That's why, as a response to God's call upon his life, everywhere he goes, he builds an altar unto the Lord. He recognizes that the key is to respond by building intimacy with God. Pag nagdi-devotional tayo, ano bang tingin mo dyan? Response o obligation? O manipulation to twist the hand of God? I have to go to church. Kung hindi ko musipa, please don't misunderstand me. We need to come to fellowship together. According to Hebrews, forsake not the assembling together. Kasi yung time that we receive fellowship, we communicate with God. Pero yung personal time mo sa Ginoo, as you respond to His love every day. Alam ba natin na tayo ang altar sa New Testament? You are the altar of God. This is just a gathering place. God dwells here. This is also an altar. But wherever you go, you are the altar. Si Abraham builds an altar everywhere he goes. Pero tayo sa New Testament, built in ang altar. Kung si Richard Jones pa, you are the dream home of the Father. You are the dream home of the Trinity. It's longing for you from eternity to eternity for you to respond to His call upon your life. When we develop intimacy, we are able to attract blessing and we are able to bless people. Di ka maghago para panalanginan ka, because when your heart is open, when you believe that God is able, when we develop intimacy, when we respond to His love, we are surrounded with favor and blessing wherever we go. Ingalaga ni ko sa mga daghang lugar kaya tuhanan mo. Karon lang ako ni siya, wag na ko na ma-share sa kinsa except sa my wife na ko. Si Bishop Leo Alconga, sir. Kawa na to permi, halos 1 year, di ba? Kabalo ka ba, sir, na every time before siya mauli, iya kong gina-bless. Imagine, before na siya mular gagakson niya ko, kumustahon niya ko na Pentecostal, kumusta? Pentecostal handshake. God bless you, Brother Troy. Hindi ko akalain yan. But when you begin to respond sa God's call sa life mo, God arranges things. Walang setback, always set up. Hello? Walang setback, always set up wherever you go. Usahay dagko, usahay gagmay, pero ang importante, dahan-dahan kinakalabit ka, sabi ng Father, "Hoy, I'm concerned about you." Hindi kita pinapabayaan, nire-remind ka palagi. So it should not be an obligation na kailang buhato na ko ni, buhato na ko na, aron panalanginan ko. Sa New Testament, when our hearts are open, we just respond. We just respond. We just respond. When Father bids us, fills us with His love, paramdaman tayo ng pagmamahal niya, we just respond, "Father, I receive." And in so doing, you are surrounded with favor. Nagay ko tigupit, basta muli ko sa labato, magpagupit ko, Muslim. Because of God's favor, first time na ako siyang giantuan, 6 o'clock in the evening, magsarado na siya kay, why customer tibok adlaw? O brad, pag doon na ako, assalamualaikum, walaikum salam sir, sabi niya. Patabungaw ako sa Maguindanao kasi ang pagupit. "Ah, magsara na kami sir kasi gabi na. Eh, pagbigyan mo lang ako, makikita mo anong mangyari. Ikaw na lang, sir, ha? Kabutan mo lang, santila sa ako, duha tayo naglingkod. Magsara na ako," sabi ko. "Di ba sabi mo, wala kang customer the whole day. Ngayon, tatlo na. Gupitan niya ako, nanapoy duha naglingkod na po." That night alone, bago naghawa, 8 ang kahulat magupit. After 3 weeks, nagbalik ipod ko. Siya na nanawag, kita yun. "Sana naman, sir, pag-upit ka, sir, ako na, libre na." Sabi ko, "Di magbayad ako." Sabi niya, "Pag-upit na," sabi niya, "Sir, may tanong ako." "May anting-anting ka?" Sabi ko, "Hindi anting-anting ang tawag sa amin. Wherever we go, kasi pastor ako, anak ako ng Diyos, I have Jesus in my heart. I am surrounded with favor." Amen? Always remember that. Before I go, buhawagin ko ko, "Father, thank you for your favor. Musakay ko, may favor per me. Sakay ko kero plano, hot good, kaya ko gugo." Oh, di ba? "Pero I ask for favor. Di na ko kinahanglan mo hangyo dito. Hangyo lang na ko aisle. Ang dito sa aeroplano, sa check-in counter, di niya ko tagaanog katapad." Sabi niya, "Sir, ang plane is almost puno. Gusto mo sa likod kita ilagay, why, walay tapad." Imagine, hanawan ko niya. "Ano ako, para sa ba? Doon lang mo na muhabot sa doon. Habot dito. Huwag ko'y tapad." Tingala na sila. Tapos usay akong katapad, pamerindahan ko. Sa pikas aisle. Pag merindan niya, "Sir, have something." Ako busog ko. "Sige na po." Imagine yung favor. Kumusta man tayo? Do we receive favor or do we work for favor? Ang favor, hindi mo yung ginahaguan. Si set up ng Diyos yan sa iyo. Wherever you go. Especially when you have developed intimacy. Pang-apat. Abraham knows his identity. Alam niya ang call. Kaya ano sabi ng Panginoon, "You are no longer Abram. You are now Abraham. And you will be the father of many nations. And you shall be a blessing to the nations." Nag-change ang kanyang identity. Sa atin, alam ba natin anong identity natin? Every time we are confronted with problems, palaging kini-question yung identity natin. Who are you? Jesus was confronted with the same question. If you are the Son of God, turn these stones into bread. Challenge permit kinsa ka? Anak ka ba ng Diyos? My daughter, every Sunday morning, bago magpunta sa church, una man na sila liguan, ilis. Tapos mag-ilis ni sa akong asawa, sarang door. Mutok-tok na akong amahuran na anak. Open the door. Bihis pa kami. This is your daughter, Andrea. Open the door. Imagine, i-demand niya ang rights niya. Alam niya, anak siya. Ako pang binuangan, what is the password? That is Big Tommy. Dali lang, open the door. I-demand nila ang rights nila. Kasi pag anak ka, alam mo anak ka. Always namin illustration sa pagiging anak. For example, kahit kami ni Pastor Edwin ay close kami, calling, lahim treatment niya sa ako kaysa siya kagaling ng anak. For example, muto ko siyang balay. Mudiritso lang ba kulingkod dito? Mahidigda sa ilang kama? Hindi pwede. Mudiritso lang ba kulingkod? Tapos, abris TV? Abris sarep? Kahon? No, siya, pagkabastos ba ng tambo ka? Pero ang anak niya, when his son arrives, manuktok pa ba? Kung abring murtahan, dili. He goes there, abre sa rin sa imakaon, mulingkod siya, mabring TV, tungtong pandil. I-question ba siya ni Pastor Erwin? No. Why? Because he is a son. Part of the family. Nakakalungkot, maraming mga Christians, tinawag na maging anak, pero ang utak, alipin. After receiving Jesus Christ, after opening the door and the gate into intimacy, alam niya na siya ay anak, nasa mind niya pero wala sa heart. Karamihan, sabi ng Father, this is your inheritance. Ang uban, mayroon lang, wow, amen, kagwapo sa inheritance, pero hangtod dito lang. Liliw nila, murag balay bagad ako, tuatanan, this is yours, tanaw niya, wow, nakakanan. Praise God. Amen. Okay, let go. Hindi po yan for display. Your being a son of God is for you to walk in it and enjoy in it and fulfill your destiny through it. Kasagaran mo ko na ito at ato Christianity hatod salvation lang. Kakalungkot. Pero I congratulate you kasi yung mga na-expose sa Father's love, alam natin hindi lang tayo hanggang dito. We have a destiny. Amen? Amen? Panglima, the last but not the least, Abraham knows his destiny. Alam niyo po, pag alam mo ikaw ay anak, alam mo may pupuntahan ka. Ilan sa atin ang nakasakay na ng rural? Or super pipe, or anong mga bus dito mabibiyahin? Bachelor. Pagsakay mo ng bus, tatanungin ka ng konduktor, asa ka ma'am, asa ka sir, sa imong tubag, bisag asa lang doon. Dili pwede. Panahugon ka. In fact, zero plano, pagsakay mo mo ng flight attendant. This flight is bound for Metro Manila. Any person that is bound for Manila, please disembark immediately. Bisag bago mo hawa sa Manila, this flight is bound for Cagayan de Oro City. Any person here not bound for Cagayan de Oro City, please disembark. When you decide to serve the Lord, there is an inner knowing sa iyo na alam mo may patutunguhan ka. Lalo na pag na-discover mo ang identity mo. You must know where you're going. We must know ano ang direksyon ng buhay mo. Maraming mga tao walang direksyon because they do not know anong status ng relationship nila sa Panginoon. This morning, ako po'y may question. Do you have dreams in your life? Sabi po ng scripture, now unto him who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, more than you ask or imagine according to the power that is at work within you. Hindi po nakadepende sa mga tao na kapalibot sa inyo. Hindi nakadepende sa circumstances because God has deposited in us eternity. Kasama doon ang pag-fulfill the dreams of God for your life. May mga dreams ba tayo? When God breathed in us His DNA, kasama po ang love, kasama ang life sa ating human spirit. Father wants us to trust Him as our Heavenly Father. Ito po aking good news today sa bawat isa. Kung may mga dreams tayo in the past, sa tanaw na to, no more na. Today, God is awakening your dreams again. Kung sa tingin mo hindi na sinagot yung prayer mo again today, God is awakening to you. Gusto ng Panginoon ma-fulfill ito by His love, not by your own strength and ability. Minsan pag hindi na-fulfill kasi ang ating dream, in our desired time, kakaroon tayo ng frustrations. Kakaroon tayo ng condemnation. Darkness comes into our lives. Today, I speak into the atmosphere. Our dormant dreams is coming alive again. Amen? Ignay mong katapat, your dormant dream is coming alive again. God is calling your dream to come alive and receive life and fulfillment. Akong gihanta na sa pagtindog. There is no more condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus. Especially when we learn to walk as sons and daughters. We are called to be perfected in love. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Father, we thank you again for your presence. Thank you, Father, because you have a purpose for our lives. Thank you. Even Father, for everyone is here. I speak into their lives, Father, the fulfillment of destiny and their dormant dreams to come alive again. I pray, Father, that every heart would respond to your purpose and calling. Hallelujah. Anyone here this morning, sa tingin mo na frustrate ka dahil may mga promises ng Father na sa tingin mo hindi mo na fulfill, I challenge you to just raise your hand wherever you are standing. Father, today I call forth again fulfillment of destiny. I call forth, Father, the dreams to be awakened again, to be quickened by your love, that everyone, Father, would begin to respond by your love. Yung mga broken dreams, Father, ng kanilang buhay, I pray for healing today by your love. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, receive love. Receive love. Receive love from the Father. Receive love from the Father. Thank you, Father God. Receive love. In Jesus' name. Amen. Palakpakan natin ang Ginoo.
Shall we all be seated quietly, please? As I we want to call Pastor Jun, come over to the pulpit to collect the offering and the tithes for this morning's service.
Good morning. Are you blessed this morning? Amen. So, when we begin to observe something long enough, we begin to see the pattern. Example, sa trabaho bitaw, when we start working, At first, murag galisod pa ka, especially for those who are nasa online. But kadugayan, makita nimo, simple na dayon. But at first, it's pressure, di pakakabisado. But after you begin to observe enough the system, long enough, you begin to see the pattern. Are you getting my point? Hello? This is what I have observed over the years in the ministry, or even over the years of a Christian, becoming over the years of my Christian life. I want you to hear this. The faithful are always blessed. Hello? You would not see this kung 1 year pa ka, 2 years, 3 years pa ka ng Christian. But makita niyo mo, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, you'll begin to see the pattern that those who live a faithful life, they are always blessed. So I came up with a conclusion, dili na dai ko kinahanglan mag-teach of prosperity. Ampon na i-teach is to teach people to be faithful. Because that is what I see. The faithful will always be blessed. In fact, ingon si Jesus, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. If you be faithful here, you will have more here, and you will have even eternal life." Mo nang ingon sa Matthew chapter 19, verse 29. "Everyone who has left houses, or brothers, or sisters, or father, or mother, or children, or land, anything for my sake, will receive 100-fold in some version in this lifetime and the life to come." Una-una ako ba? So kung naalugar ko i-give up nga balay din, hey, so God will give me 100 more houses? No, not necessarily like that. Sagingon pa ni Pastor Troy, when we are soaked in the love of the Father, we begin to be content. Okay? And this is what I have observed. You know, when I was starting ministry, daghang job offers sa ako. But I declined it. And when I won my first soul, not my soul, but when I won the first soul, nagipaminister ni Lord sa ako, nakaingong ko, "This is worth more than ₱1,000,000. Ang joy bitaw nga, dili ni mo mabayaran. James chapter 1 verse 12, "Great blessings belong to those who are tempted and remain faithful." Say with me, great blessings. Ang sabi ni siya sa great? Sabi ni siya sa great? Dako. Or kung English na ni mo, big man, di ba? It's more than big, it's great, di ba? Ang sabi ni siya sa blessing? Dako nga panalangin. Kinsay gusto ana? And ingon sa James, "Great blessings belong to those who are tempted and remain faithful." You see, you cannot be faithful unless you go through shaking. In fact, faithfulness is tested by time and shaking. Saan man nagbinisaya, be? Kasi ka nabinisaya sa faithful? Ang matinud-anon, matistingan lang nani mo sa panahon. O panahon na gitayog ka. You can never be considered faithful kung dugay na ka Christian ni ayahay ang kinabuhi. Kaya kung mag-Kristohanon ka namang gawin mga pagsulay. But if you remain faithful in those trying times, you will have great blessing right here in the life to come. In fact, the word faithfulness means a firm adherence to the truth and to the duties of religion. Now, sino naman yung endurance, those who stay, remain, patience? In my word, those who do not give up because you believe in the truth. Now, let me connect this to tithing. How many people give up tithing because they don't see any return? This is what I have observed. First, pag aning ka nga muhatag, bubalik, dayo na. And then, sige na din ko gatag kay kabalo ko, mubalik. But over time, tingala ko nga, wala na may gabalik. In fact, there was one time, nagikwinta na ako, kaya I have records, gaga-record ko sa contact. I do not really kanang write it down, but I have a record, siguro rough record lang sa akong giving and tithing. Ako ang gikwintahan si Lord, Lord, kung kato mga years nga gipanghatag na ako, imo nang gibalik, multimillionaire na unta ako. Pero nganong wala pa man, Lord? Okay? Saturday, sa pagkakristuhano, at first, ibuhos na ni Lord sa imo, mga first prayers ni mo, tubago niya, mga first giving ni mo, iyang ipanghatag. But over the time, that there will be a time of, this is what I have observed, na a time of testing to see if you are really faithful. Okay? And once God has proven you faithful, there will be great blessing in this life and the life to come. That is the pattern I have seen in my life, and that is the pattern that I have seen in the life of others. Not just in the areas of finances. I see people who are anointed, I can see that they have lived the pattern, they have gone through the pattern. Because blessing is not just finances, it's in all aspects of our life. Now my question to you is, do you want great blessing? James chapter 1, verse 12, great blessings belongs to those who are tempted and remain faithful. I'm telling you, if you don't have feeling ni mo nga, you don't feel like tithing right now, mora mag-yapon. Okay? Remain faithful. Tanan mo, over the years, pilan ako, ikapilan na, sige na ako, hatag-tithe, mora, wala man. Galisod pa bang yapon ko? Just remain faithful. Just remain faithful. Okay? Wala na magkikimakaon, mag-tithe pag yun. Just remain faithful. And I'm telling you, at the end, you'll see the pattern. And when the Lord blesses you, He will add no trouble to it. If you've experienced that verse, makaingon ka nga, Lord, this is so much. This is too much. Makamayon ka, Lord, night time ba, managin ko nga, Lord, sobra naman kayo ni Lord. Ay. And then, you know, the Lord spoke to me and said, you deserve it. You deserve it. Not just in the area of finances, okay? In many areas of your life. Just remain faithful. Tell your neighbor, remain faithful. Amen. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for your teaching us to be faithful. And Father, for those of us who have been faithful over the years, Lord, I pray that this may be the time for you to open up the heaven's doors, the heaven's gates, the floodgates of heaven, and pour out, O God, the great blessings that you have promised for those who are faithful. And Father, for those who are still starting, Lord, I pray that you give us the grace to remain faithful. Thank you so much, Father God, for your word. Thank you so much for your presence. And thank you so much for every giver this morning. This I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you as you give.